Let's say you got a really crazy family. There's kids around. There's chickens and pigs roaming around the house. The lights be flickering. There's loud music. Let's just say your house is just chaotic, right? And so it's hard for you to create content because there's never a quiet time when you're at home by yourself, or you're scared to even do it when you are, because you never know when somebody's gonna bust in your room or come in there. Like, you're just petrified and you can't even create content, right? That thing, that fear, is hindering your success. When you can just say, "Hey, welcome to my crazy life on affiliate marketing. Guys, pardon me if you hear a crazy noise or a pig walks in. That's my life. And one of the reasons I'm trying to grow on social media and build affiliate marketing so I can buy my own place." Right? Now it's so much easier. Now, if they come in and get crazy, you don't even have to explain. They know it, they'll laugh, and you keep going, right? But you use that as an advantage, not as your setback. Same thing is what I did as an introvert. I just told everybody. Now it's out there, and I don't have to pretend or hide it or try hard to look like I'm not an introvert. It's already out there. The cool thing is, I attract the introverts, and they're gonna bond with me. And they're gonna get to know, like, and trust me a whole lot faster because I was honest. But anyway, today we're gonna be talking about creating fire content. So I'm gonna show you some examples. The way the world is going, people, this generation, but consumers and customers as a whole, are a whole lot smarter because they've been screwed over and over so many times, and now their guards are up. So now more and more people are buying from people. So you have to learn the art of selling without selling. You have to have more patience. But more importantly, you have to understand what we call the buyer's journey. When you understand the buyer's journey, you can create the content correctly and with a strategy. This is what people skip. We get the product, we build the business, we set it up, but we don't create a strategy with the consumer in mind. We create a strategy for the quickest way that we can make money, right? But it should be flipped, because the money comes with the customer who's paying us and is happy to pay if they see the value in the product. But the big bucks come in when you help them solve that problem or achieve that goal or those results. So when you're creating content and when you're creating a strategy, when you're picking and choosing your products, when you're building the business, you have to build the business with the consumer in mind, because they make up your business. They are your viewers. They are your subscribers. They are giving you their email address, right? And ultimately, they have the money. It'll take you years and years if you do not grasp that. You're in this business to serve. That's why it's called customer service. You are an affiliate marketer, you're a digital marketer, you're a coach, or whatever you are, but you're serving the people. All right, they make up your business. We're at their mercy. The sooner that you can grab hold of that and really let that in and let that embody you, you're going to be highly successful in this business. A lot of people make it very far from the behind the scenes, building it, finding it, setting it up, automations, emails, boom. But then when it comes to the most important part, which is marketing, which leads to traffic, which leads to clicks, which leads to sales, people skip that part or half do it. And like we talked about, some people try and fake it, and these customers can see right through it. So I'm going to get into my ebook. I'm going to share the screen. But number four is create fire content and connect with your audience. Keywords, and. All right, we're creating fire content with the intent to connect with our audience. All right, so I'm just going to read some excerpts through this. All right. So the reality, the massive commissions or massive sales. All right. to be successful at affiliate marketing or at any other business on extraordinary levels, you must create high quality content. All right, high quality, yes, if you can have great audio, great visuals, cool transitions, grading, all that technical stuff, yes, that does help. But remove all of that if you're and people have to go solely off what you're saying, right? And that is at 0% versus 100% high quality visual content. As far as post-production, you're going to fail. What I mean by high quality content is that you're really connecting and really talking to your audience. And it has to be something that they're interested in. You can try your hardest to talk about 8-track tapes that came out in the 70s. All right. But only you are probably going to be interested in it. And if you're trying to sell it, you're going to have the hard time trying to do that as well. People, as a majority, aren't interested in that. So you have to make sure that whatever you're talking about, people are interested in. All right. That way you can seamlessly plug your affiliate links. If you find your audience's problems by doing extensive research, all right, it's not just a quick Google search, but extensive research, right? You will grow a prosperous community of raging fans and buyers. So when we're looking at the people that are making the 10K a month that you're seeing, when you're looking at the coaches and the gurus and all those people you're inspired by, that you're motivated to pursue this business, right? You have to understand they're taking these extra, extra, extra extensive steps in order to become successful. And they're doing that and becoming successful at it because very, very few other people are doing it. We're just doing the basics. We just post a video, right? But we didn't strategically say, what can I say to them that's going to get them to watch me? Because of the value of your content, people will connect and get to know, like, and trust you. And moreover, they will buy from your leaks for years. I have people that have been, I call these people, it's a handful of them. They're in a whole nother separate group. We're kind of like family now. These were like my first customers, but they've been with me since day one, going on 5 years now.
Wow.
Everything I drop, they buy. Matter of fact, they test it and buy it for me before it hits the whole world. They watch my videos and give me feedback. But that's how powerful relationships between seller and buyers can be. All right. So this is something I had to do, and we all got to do this. You have to find your voice. These are things I can teach you, but I can't teach you, if that makes sense. Right?
Makes sense.
I can only show you how to find you, but I can't tell you how to find you because you're you, right? Because we're so different. If we had the same audience, you had a thousands of people in your Instagram following, and I had 1,000, and we switched and we were selling the same thing, we wouldn't make any money because our people are different, because we're different. So here are my top tips about how to find your voice on social media. Now, a lot of people will always tell you, I just don't know what to put on social media. I am business to business. I am traditionally in a boring industry, and I don't know what to post. I don't know how to make myself stand out differently. All right. The things that I want you to think about on social media are really simple, and they're going to make you stand out, and they're going to make you feel more confident in your social media, and are things that will get you more engaged with your followers as well. And it's just be human. And what I say, mean by be human, is be yourself. Your best differentiator against all your competition, the only thing we all truly got, is nobody in this whole entire world is you. That is your advantage. Now, the cool thing about that, the same way in business is also the same way in life. When you're growing up and we get into the social world, when we go to school, middle school, high school, and college, And then out in the world, we make friends. And a lot of those friends turn out to be our best friends and longtime best friends that we grow old with. They only became friends with you because of who you are. This is the same way it works on social media. So if you approach it as, I'm going to put myself out there, introduce myself, and connect with people and make friends, they just happen to be friends that are interested in what I'm selling or the content I'm putting out. But only you can reach them and connect with them. Only you can even explain things the way you can explain them. In my private communities, I tell people how to do this, but I make sure they understand how to take this information that I'm teaching them and be able to explain it to their audience. It's like translating it. For example, you guys are learning what I'm saying because I know how to talk to you guys versus somebody else who's highly more educated than I am and uses big words and all these terminologies and acronyms. They would confuse you and make you feel overwhelmed. I know I have to break this down by piece by piece. I know I have to check for understanding because I would need it if it was being done for me. And I am attracting a reflection and mirrors of myself. Everything else that you don't know, the sheer execution of it, you will learn. Don't worry about all the stuff you don't know. Just start. You don't know how it's going to turn out. When that first person who ends up that you didn't know was going to be your best friend just says, hey, how you doing? Or you don't know how it's going to turn out when you say, hey, my name's Ronnie. How you doing? You don't know what's going to happen or when they react when you say, hey, I'm really into Transformers. What about you? They could laugh at you and call you a nerd, but you don't know that, but you take the risk. But we don't say if that person rejects us, I'm not making any friends anymore. Friends are liars, they're scammers. No more human beings around me, right? No, we go make other friends. Same thing with relationships, all right? And I get it for all those people offline. We're like, yeah, there's some people like that. Overall, guys, bear with me, all right? But in relationships, some people will get rejected or even dumped or even mistreated by a woman or a man. Most people are not going to say, oh, women are bad. I'm never doing this again. I'll just be single. They'll get over it and they'll try again. All right. This is how it works in your journey with putting out content. Don't worry that you don't know how to edit the videos. Don't worry about you don't know what to say or you're nervous or all those things. Just understand you're not making content for those people who don't understand that you're just starting out. The people who do understand is your target audience, and they're going to get it and they're going to connect with you. You're only making content for them. They will discover on their own that you are not for them, and that's what you want. Now, no, this may some people feel uncomfortable, but you need to market your business. And social media is a great way to do that. You can't sit in your office and hope that people are going to find you. It's not going to happen. There's only two ways to do this. You have to pay for ads or you got to put out organic traffic. Everybody got to do that. That's it. Third thing is cold emailing and stuff, but that could be expensive. And if it's free, it's going to be very tedious. All right. But you have, whatever you do, you have to put yourself out there as a business owner. You have to understand this. You will not make money if you're not putting out some form of content to where you're spreading the word about your business. Period. You're not going to drive a car without gas. You're not going to not be hungry unless you feed yourself. These are just how this whole business works and this world works. You have to put out something to get something back. All right? We won't eat unless we work to make money to buy the food. This is what you have to understand. There's no way around that. There's harder ways of doing it, and you can make it as complicated or as simple as possible. But the fact still remains, nobody, and I mean absolutely nobody, is going to make money if they're not putting out content and you're trying to make money online. Now, people buy from people, and they are very nosy. People want to know what you're up to, what you're doing behind the scenes of the business. All right. Like I said, the more you reveal, the easier it becomes to you. And that doesn't mean that you have to reveal everything. You have a right to your privacy. but understand that, all right? By being human and putting yourself out there really is the way that you can make yourself stand out on social media. Where most people fail is they quit too soon. And the reason they quit too soon is because they didn't build the strategy on it, which includes them knowing who their audience is and the journey from where they are to where we're trying to get them. Some people come into this business, and sometimes I ask them, not sometimes, but almost all the times, by the time they get to me, I say, how long have you been following me? Oh man, I've been seeing you on social media for at least a year, probably longer. And every time I see you, Ronnie, man, you just be putting out great content. I love watching it. I like everything you talk about. I really connect with you. I'm like, cool, man. What made you finally go ahead and start investing in yourself? I'm like, man, you just hit me. It just hit me with this last video, and I just went on ahead and did it and blah, blah, blah. All right, cool. Then they'll come into this business. I coach them, and then they go out, and they're expecting fast results. So they'll say 3 months down the road, man, Ronnie, I didn't know it was going to take this long, man. I was hoping that I would have this or hit these goals or whatever. What's going on? Like, nothing. You're doing everything right. Just keep going. That doesn't mean stop or get discouraged. You're on the road to success. Keep going. Learn from your business, what you're doing, and improve and keep improving. But you're going to get there. Right. But the crazy thing is, what I asked them, I said, remind yourself, it took you over in a year to become a customer of mine. How can you not at least be patient with those coming in after you? Now, you're going to have to be the expert in your field. And that doesn't mean you have to know everything all at once. You just got to be one step ahead of the people that are following you. You can literally go online and learn something and just put it out the world. And that's as far as you've gotten. But people want to be led, and they would trust you because they feel like you know what you're talking about. And also in the transparency, you could talk about that as well. I've seen some of my students say, I was today years old when I found out this. That's how they start off their content. That's their hook. So they literally just learned it and they told somebody, all right? But the customer perceives you as an expert. Now, my expertise is obviously marketing, social media, branding, and all that stuff. But you got to be the expert in your field. So think about, you got to understand that you got to educate your audience. You can't just put out mindset content. You can do this. You can't just show income. Even if you've had success, you can't just do this. You got to educate them people. They have to see the value and understand why they should invest. They have to see and visualize themselves doing what you're doing. So if you look at my YouTube videos, I'm literally walking them through that process that I'm teaching them. And they're doing that with me, right? The psychology of that, they're seeing that it's not as hard as they thought. And they're visualizing, actually they're more than visualizing, they're materializing themselves in their minds, joining my program or purchasing my product or signing up for that affiliate program. So find out your customers' burning questions. What are those things that people really get stuck on when it comes to what you do? And if you have a hard time figuring that out, ask yourself, what was the hardest thing for you to get started? What was the hardest thing or the first hardest thing after you started? What are you struggling with right now? Those problems that you've already found the solutions for is the beginning forms of your content because it is the path you've already walked. So if you look at my courses or a lot of my products, I'm going back to that place when I was doing that. So just as quick as you educate them and they believe you and they're really pumped up, one crazy thought will pop in their head and tell them, nah, you know, you don't need to do that, right? You got to come down back with them and resonate with them on that level as well. Everybody has a story. And I'm sure every one of you has a backstory, whether you've come from what you've done, what you've studied, where you've lived, places you've traveled, things you've seen, places you've worked, work experience, whatever it is. Think about your backstory and inspire people with that. The reason I started my business was because I became homeless. I tell people about that because it resonates with them. What if you're an introvert like me? I refuse to let introvertism stop me or hold me back from success. My coach, he said, imagine you had a fear of water. And he said, but your child is in a pool drowning. Are you not going to dive in the water to attempt to save your child? That clicked in me when he said that. Inside of us, we all have something that we're all uncomfortable doing, but given that right opportunity, we would ignore all of that for something greater. So yeah, you may not be tech savvy. Yeah, you may be an introvert. Yeah, you don't know how to work social media. Yeah, you don't know how to talk to people. Yeah. That's cool. That's you. And that's your real truth. That is not an excuse for you to do what you need to do in order to be successful, especially in this day and age with artificial intelligence, you guys. Now, in this ebook, I give you some examples. I won't go through all of that. But find out what works for you, but start. Okay? However you start social media, start. Get good at whatever you chose. But we're not going to go back and hide inside of our shells because we say this thing. We are this thing. I'm a slow learner. I'm an introvert. I'm camera shy. I don't have a camera. I don't have a phone. I don't have internet. So. You gotta do something about it. And you gotta find a workaround about it. All right, so what do you post? First, you gotta find your voice. All right, cancel it out, cut it out, block anyone that makes you feel less than worthy, delete old friends. I blocked all of my people on social media who I already knew was gonna laugh at me or tell me I'm doing something stupid. All those people you don't talk to anymore that are making you afraid to be your true self. Create a whole new account or whatever you got to do. But you got to be a force to be reckoned with. And I know you may not feel that way right now, but darn, you're just getting started. And this is how I know, because you're here.